Hey y'all, it's Dora. Today, it's all about scent diffusers. I absolutely had to do this video because it is definitely my favorite outlet for scent. I sit at my desk a lot doing videos for my other channel, A Splash of Color, which is about watercolor painting. Anyways, I like to have a nice scent going on while I'm sitting at my desk. I prefer this over candles, wax melts, potpourri, room spray, whatever. I find this scent stronger than anything else. Make sure to prep the diffuser flowers correctly so they're not wobbly and they don't fall off the reed stick. Simply grab a pointed edge and stick it directly in the bottom center of the flower. Also, make sure the hole is big enough for the reed stick. This step is highly recommended. A wired cotton wick secures the sola flower so it doesn't fall out the vase. It also enables you to put more than one flower in a vase. And a wire gives you the option to bend the flowers in an aesthetically pleasing pose. In case you're wondering or worried, this will not affect your sola flower or its ability to suck up scent in any way. Just don't mess with it more than you have to and don't unwind or unravel the wick. No need to go out and buy a vase. Your house is bound to have something you can use for this project. Any bottle that is short and has a wider base with a very narrow neck will be just perfect. I also just want to let you know the internet says not to use plastic bottles. However, I have found that they work perfectly fine. For this recipe, you're going to need scent and alcohol. I also mentioned carrier oil because every recipe I've ever come across has this. However, I've used recipes without it, and the scent potency is the same. I like to put a few drops of color in my scent so that I can watch the scent's progress as it travels. The flowers will become more colorful by the day as it soaks up more scent. Alternatively, the flowers will lose color when the scent runs out, so adding a bit of color will act as a tank indicator, letting you know when it's time to refill. I jumpstart scent by dropping some directly on the flowers. You don't have to do this, the flowers will soak it up on their own. However, this will take a few hours to start smelling and about a week to become fully saturated. More on this on the rose that we didn't jumpstart in about a minute. It's amazing to me how thirsty these flowers are. With all that scent poured on top, these flowers drank the entire recipe in a little over a week. but that's how I like it. I prefer to have to refill more often and get a strong scent day after day for about a week. Plus, keep in mind that there are four flowers in the vase. For weaker flowers that you don't have to refill as often, add less alcohol. Flip reed sticks after a few hours to jumpstart their scent. It's also a good idea to flip them a few times a month as well. These disperse scent, however, they only put out about a quarter of the scent that the flowers do. Thanks for watching, guys. All of the items used in this tutorial will be linked in the description. If you guys like this video, please click the thumbs up. And if you found it helpful or inspirational, you should subscribe. Don't miss out on weekly creative ideas and videos.